Hi, AT from CNC at home. I'd like to go through and talk about the print and cut feature within LightBurn. There's an option that allows you to scale. There's also a no scaling, which I've used in the past, where I've measured everything out exactly where I needed it to be. Sometimes you don't have time for that, or it really doesn't matter, and you can be a little loose with that, and using just the regular align output to target will allow LightBurn to rescale and adjust your image to your target material. That's what I want to talk about today. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Let's go over and put a piece of material onto the laser and see how that works. I'm just going to take a business card and throw it on there. I'll need to bring the laser head over and get that focused. Once it's focused, I'll go ahead and zero the laser, as we do need to work in absolute coordinates, so it's important for things to be aligned up correctly. Now that the laser has been homed, I'll go ahead and move the laser head over to the business card blank and get it moved down into approximately the lower left-hand corner, which the card is skewed, isn't quite the lower left-hand corner, relatively. That's where this print and cut feature is going to come in and save us a ton of time in measuring and adjusting. Okay, so we have that in our first spot. Let's go back to LightBurn and get our project started and then use the print and cut feature to get everything lined up. I'm going to open a business card that I've done in the past. We'll go ahead and zoom in on this. This is for a friend of mine who's the director at Endon. I made him one of these cards, and since I happen to have this handy, I'll just go ahead and use this one again. I want to make sure that my cutting parameters are correct for the purple or pink business card blank. So we're going to business cards, and I called it pinkish. Let's go ahead and assign that value. And everything's all ready to go. If we do a preview, everything's all nice and set. This will take just over 7 minutes to do, so not too bad. I need to get a couple registration marks set up, so let's do this. Let's go into our shape properties and change our corner radius to 0. That'll give us a nice sharp corner. And then what I want to do is bring in or make a target that I can use for my registration mark. Now that I've zoomed out, let's go ahead and make a quick registration mark. I'm going to just take this circle and I'm going to hold down the shift key so that it makes it an actual circle. If I don't do a circle, I can make an ellipse. And I want an absolute circle, so let's go ahead and do that. Let's get this moved onto one of our construction layers because I don't need it to be cut out. I just need it for reference. And let's change its size. Let's make it quite a bit smaller. Let's make it 10 millimeter circle. What I want to do is take the circle that I created and I'm going to plop it right on the corner here. I'm going to right click it and say duplicate and take this one and plop it on the corner down here. Let's do that again so that you can see that. I'm going to zoom in. I zoomed in a little bit too much. Okay, now let's zoom in. If I have an object selected and I tell it that I want to see that using this zoom to frame option, it'll zoom in to just that single item. If nothing is selected, then we kind of get to see everything. It didn't count my construction layers, however. So okay, so let's grab this, and as we move it into the corner, you'll see that it snaps. See, it's kind of locked right now. I can move the cursor and it's not moving. It's snapped into that corner. That's where I need it to be. Now that I have my two registration marks, now I can go into the print and cut feature. First, select I'm going to select my object. Now I can go into the print and cut feature and say that's my first target. So if we look back at the laser real quickly, you know, I'm not really in that spot. I'm not off the card in its actual corner, but I don't care. This will end up being a little bit smaller. It'll shrink it up. And I also don't have to care about its aspect ratio. If my template that I have in LightBurn is a little bit different ratio, it's higher or not as wide, the print and cut feature is going to adjust that for me so that it all fits correctly. So let's do this. Let's go ahead and go into move, and let's take a look at the laser. I'm going to go to my second spot. So I'll just move over and then up. A little more over, back down just a little bit. I'm going to go into step mode here and just move. I'm going to move 1 millimeter at a time at the moment so I can get this about where I need it. Again, the whole idea here is not to be super accurate, but close enough to get the desired results we want. So that's in a location that should work fine. I have my second registration mark selected. Go into print and cut. Say that's my second one. Go back into print and cut. And now I want to say align output to target. Normally, like I said before, is I use the no scaling, so it does it exactly how I have measured everything up. This time I'm being a little loosey-goosey, so I'm going to say align it to my target, and it's going to scale it to fit between those two points so that my two registration marks will be where I said they were. So we'll go ahead and say align to that, and we're all ready to go. Let's go ahead and do the burn and see what happens. The laser is doing a good job. It's putting the burn right exactly where I needed it to be. It's scaling it to fit the card, and I didn't have to do any measuring. I didn't have to align my business card with the laser. So using print and cut this way can save you a lot of time when that high precision isn't needed and you just need approximately here. Use print and cut. It'll do a lot of the work for you. I hope you enjoyed this video and learned a little something about the print and cut feature. If you did, give it a thumbs up. We always like to get positive feedback. If you like the content of our channel, think about subscribing. That always helps us out. Enjoy doing your CNC at home projects.
Oops.